Everyone, Patrick CK here with a quick tip for my fellow YouTubers who are looking to branch out from their primary channel by creating secondary, tertiary, or more channels. It's a good idea to create new channels when introducing new brands or content that would otherwise not be suitable for your primary channel and its audience. One important thing to remember when creating new outlets is that even though you already have a channel that's met the monetization thresholds, any new channel you create will have to meet those thresholds on their own. Knowing this, you may want to consider promoting your new channel on your other channels to meet those metrics as soon as possible. Just a reminder, using the 2020 Partner Program checklist, you need to have 1,000 subscribers and have 4,000 hours of valid public watch time before you can be considered for monetization on any content uploaded to the new channel. Since YouTube likes changing up the interface now and again, the method for doing this is slightly different than it was just a few months ago, before the full rollout of YouTube Studio. It may change again in the next year or two, but for now, this is how you add another channel to your account. From the Studio dashboard, select Settings near the bottom of the menu in the left column. In the Settings pop-up window, go to Channel. From the Channel window, select the Advanced Settings tab. Scroll to the bottom of this window. Under Other Settings, select Manage YouTube Account. Now, in the YouTube Account screen, under your YouTube channel, select Add or Manage your channels. In the next window, you'll see a list of all the channels associated with your primary YouTube account. Finally, you can select the Create a New Channel button and follow the steps to finalize the creation of your new channel. This seems a little more cumbersome than it used to be from within the Classic interface, but since Classic has been completely removed, you don't really have a choice in the matter. To hopefully make it a little easier for you, I've provided the link directly to the YouTube channel screen in the description. That way you can completely bypass all the steps above, that is until the URL changes. The good news is, from what I can tell, you can have unlimited channels associated with your YouTube account, which is nice, especially if you have multiple brands to manage, as you can control all of them from one account and still allow for delegating permissions to others, which makes future management that much easier. That's it for this quick tip. I hope it helps you out. If it did, leave a like and share so others can find this content in the future. Until next time, this has been Patrick CK. Goodbye.